This is a previous year KQ problem, normal distribution. So we will discuss few problems here. Okay. So first there are five problems. First I will do fourth problem. So that is a direct problem. So we will do fourth problem first. So which is a comparatively easy problem. So this is the fourth problem. And let me so this is our fourth problem. So the problem is the time required to assemble a piece of machinery is a random variable having approximately a normal distribution with a mean 12.9 minutes and standard deviation 2 minutes. So what is normal distribution? Random variable x is time required to assemble a piece of machinery. Okay, so with the mean and standard deviation is given, and what are the probabilities that the assembly of piece of a machinery of this kind will take, first one, at least 11.5 minutes. Second one, anywhere from 11 minutes to 14 minutes. So these are the first question. So this is a direct question. So I will solution. So the solution. So we can write. So what is x normal distribution is? So let x denote the time required to assemble, time required to assemble a piece of machinery. Okay, so and we have given normal, it follows normal distribution, therefore x follows normal distribution with what is mean? Mean is approximately this, right? 12.9. So mean is given 12.9, and standard deviation is mu is 12.9, and we have given standard deviation 2 minutes. So sigma is equal to 2 minutes. Okay. So 2 minutes. So what are the probability that the assembly of a piece of machinery will this gain will take at least 11.5 minutes? So what we have to do, we have to find P of first one, P of x. Tell me what we have to find. P of x time required to anybody? P of x. Anybody? So that is at least 11.5 minutes. So P of, is it x greater than 11.5 minutes or x less than, greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to? So we have to find the probability that assembly of required to assemble a piece of machinery x greater than, right? Greater than or equal to 11.5. So now we know that if x follows, we know that x follows normal mu sigma, then z equal to what is x minus mu by sigma follows normal 0 1. So if we can change it into a standard normal table or normal distribution, we can use standard normal table. So what we will do is we will change it into 10. So x minus mu by sigma, this is equal to sigma, this is greater than or equal to 11.5 minus mu by sigma. So so this is equal to, this I can written as P of x minus mu by sigma is z, right? Z, that is standard normal. This is greater than or equal to 11.5 minus, what is mean? Mean is 12.9 divided by sigma is 2. Okay. So this is equal to P of z greater than or equal to P of z greater than or equal to 11.5 minus 12.9 divided by 2. So if you calculate this, you will get minus 0.7. So here minus 0.7. So we have P of z greater than or equal to minus 0.7. This can be written. So if we draw this, we have normal table, this 0 minus 0.7. So somewhere minus 0.7. So what we have to calculate? We have to calculate this area greater than or equal to minus 0.7. So this is actually 1 minus P of z less than or equal to minus 0.7. So now we will calculate this. This is 1 minus. Okay. So we can take the table minus 0.7. Minus 0.7. Okay, this is the value. Minus 0.7. Minus 0.7. Minus 0.7 is here. So minus 0.7 is 0.2420. 0.2420. 0.2420. So 1 minus 0.2420 is 0.7580. So this is the answer. So this is the answer for first question. Okay. So the probability that x greater than or equal to 11.5 is 0.7580. Now what is the second question? So we have to, next we have to calculate anywhere from 11 to 14.8. So the second question is,
excuse me sir,
tell me.
Condition നമ്മള് 1 മൈനസ് ലേക്ക് മാറ്റുമ്പോഴേ
1 മൈനസ്
p of z less than or equal to വേണോ?
ഓക്കേ, വേണോ? ഒരു ഇതെന്താന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, ഇപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ ആണെങ്കിൽ, കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് റാൻഡം വേരിയബിൾ ആണെങ്കിൽ ഇതിലൊരു കുഴപ്പമില്ല. കാരണം നമ്മൾ ഇപ്പം ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ ഒരു ഒരു ക്വാണ്ടിറ്റി ആണ് ആഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, പി ഓഫ് സെഡ് ഈക്വൽ ടു മൈനസ് 0.7. ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ, ഇവിടെ ഒരു ഡിഫറൻസ് വരിക ഇതാണ്. ഇതിൽ നിന്ന് നമുക്ക് 0.7 ഈ ഒരു ക്വാണ്ടിറ്റി അധികമായിട്ട് വരും. ബട്ട് കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷനിൽ ഒരു പോയിന്റിലുള്ള പ്രോബബിലിറ്റി എപ്പോഴും സീറോ ആയിരിക്കും. ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓൾവേസ് സീറോ. സോ നമുക്ക് പി ഓഫ് എ ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു എക്സ് ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു ബി ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു പി ഓഫ് എ ലെസ് ദാൻ എക്സ് ലെസ് ദാൻ ബി. ദർ ഇസ് നോ പ്രോബ്ലം ഇൻ ഈക്വാലിറ്റി ആൻഡ് ഓൺലി ഇഫ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ. ഓക്കെ, കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് റാൻഡം വേരിയബിൾ ആണെങ്കിൽ ദർ ഇസ് നോ ഡിഫറൻസ്. ബട്ട് ഇഫ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ ഡിസ്ക്രീറ്റ് റാൻഡം വേരിയബിൾ, ഡെഫിനറ്റ്ലി ദർ ഈസ് എ ഡിഫറൻസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഐദർ വി ക്യാൻ റൈറ്റ് പി ഓഫ് സെറ്റ് ഗ്രേറ്റർ ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു 0.5, ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു, ദർ ഇസ് നോ പ്രോബ്ലം. ഓക്കെ, ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് ക്ലിയർ?
താങ്ക് യു.
So I will delete this and we will do the second problem. Okay, so next problem is next question. Anywhere between 0, so 11, second question, P of x in between 11.11 and 14.11, less than or equal to x less than or equal to 14.8. Okay, and for this also we know that x follows normal 12.9. So we will convert it into normal distribution. P of 11 minus mu by sigma less than or equal to x minus mu by sigma less than or equal to 14.8 minus mu by sigma. This is equal to, so this is equal to P of 11 minus mu, we know that it is 12.9 divided by 2 less than or equal to, this quantity is z less than or equal to 14.8 minus 12.9 divided by 2. So this is equal to, so if we calculate this 11 minus 12.9 divided by 2 is minus 0.95. So if you calculate this, you will get minus 0.95. Less than or equal to, or strictly less than, anything, there is no problem. 14.8 minus 12.9 divided by 2. So that is equal to 0.95, right? Okay, 14.8 minus 12.9 divided by 2. Okay, 0.95. Now we will calculate this. Before going to that, I will just draw our normal curve. So what we have to do, z less than or equal to 0. So this side is negative side, minus 0.95, and this is 0.95. So we have to calculate this area. This area. Okay. So we have to calculate this area. So for that, I can write this is actually equal to P of Z. We will get probability from 0.95. That is Z less than or equal to 0.95. So we will get whole area, and what we want the area here, right? So what we will do is we will subtract z less than or equal to this 0.-0.9. So from the table we can get 0.95 P of z less than, so here there is a positive table. Positive table ended. Okay, this is the positive table 0.95. So I will take 0.9 is here and the 95 is here. 0.8289. 0.8289. 0.8289. Minus, next we have to calculate this 0.-0.95. So that is 0.95. So here 0 -0.9. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the 0.1711. 0.1711. That is the answer. Now, what will be the answer? 0.6578. So this is the answer. Have you got it? So if we want to get this probability, what we will do is we will subtract from this probability by this. Okay, so now we will move to first problem. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. So first problem is a very important problem. This is a different type of problem. In a normal distribution, if 6% of the items are below 60 and 39% are above 70, then find mean and standard deviation. So this is very important problem. So here we doesn't give the mean and variance or standard deviation. So we have to find what is the mean and standard deviation. So this is KTU's September 2020 question. So that means we have given a normal distribution and 6% of the items are below 60, 39% are above 70. Find mean and standard deviation. So what we will do is, so we know that I will reduce. Answer. I will reduce. So we have given a normal distribution. So let x follows normal, mu, sigma, and we don't know what is mu and what is sigma. So this we doesn't know. Okay. Now, so given if 6% of the items are below 60, that means probability of x below 60, that is x less than 60, is equal to how many percentage? 6%, that is 0.06. And p of x here, 39% are above 70. That means p of x greater than 70 is 39%. That is probability of x greater than 70 is equal to 39%. That is 0.39. Okay, now we want to find out mean and variance. So this is a somewhat important problem. So what we will do is, we will change it into standard. Okay, first P of, this I can written as P of x minus mu by sigma less than 60 minus mu by sigma, which is equal to 0.06. So which implies P of, that means we will get two equations consisting of mu and sigma, and we will solve and find a mu and sigma. P of x minus mu by sigma is z less than 60 minus mu by sigma is equal to 0.06. Now, something less than x, z less than this quantity is equal to 0.06. So now we want to find out this quantity. Suppose this is z alpha, then this quantity we have to find. So this quantity we can find from the table. We have to check where this probability is. So if we draw the standard normal table, sorry, normal curve, this is zero, probability 0.06. So this is zero. So we have the area under this curve is, at this point is 0.06. So this is in the negative side. So this is 60 minus mu by sigma. So this point. So that means this quantity is a negative quantity. Okay. Have you got it? Because here probability is 0.06. That is P of Z less than or equal to 60 minus mu is 0.06. We know that the total area is equal to 1 and 0.5 region is here and remaining is here. So this is symmetric. So we want, we have 0.06. So now from the table, we have to find out where this is. So from the table, okay, tell me.
The value we have is less than 0.5. That's why we moved to the negative side.
Yes,
right?
Yes, correct. Okay. It is Thanks. Less than 0.5, so we move to negative side. So I want to check where is 0.06 probability. So 0.06. So it is somewhere here it is 0. Here it is 0.0606 and here it is 0.0. Okay, so here it is 0.0606, and here it is 0.594. Okay, remaining things are bigger. So we have get two values. What is this value? So okay, 0 minus 1.5. So minus 1.5. here. So these are the two conditions. So these are the two quantities. Now, okay, 0.06. So what we will do is we will take the average of these two. So here 0.0606 and here 0.594. So I want the value 0.06. Here we have to calculate this value. So which implies 60 minus mu by sigma is equal to what we will do is minus 1.55 and minus 1.56 average. So what is that? So what we will do here, we will take the average of both. So this quantity is minus 1.55 plus minus 1.56 divided by 2. So the answer is in 0.55, minus 1.55 plus minus 1.56 divided by 2. So I will get the value is minus 1.555. Have you got it? So why this happens? 0.06 in the probability of under the, but in the table we get only 0.0606 and here it is 0.0594. So it is between both. So what we will do is we will take the average of these two and that will be the value. So that is the best approximation. So therefore, which implies 60 minus mu by sigma is equal to minus 1.555. So now I will get a equation from here. So the equation is 60 minus mu is equal to minus 1.555 sigma. It implies mu, okay, if I am taking mu the other side, mu minus 1.555 sigma is equal to 60. So I can call this as equation number 1. So I got an equation which involves mu and sigma. Now from here, now we will calculate this probability. Similarly, here we can write P of x minus mu by sigma greater than 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 0.39. Now, this implies P of z greater than 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 0.39. That means and this probability is less than 0.5. So this is somewhere in the negative. Okay, 70 minus mu by sigma. So here, okay. So we have this probability is greater than 0.39. Now I want to get this. So what I will do is, So this is this implies these two are equal, therefore I can write 1 minus p of z less than or equal to 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 1 minus 0.39. Okay. Now, which implies P of Z. I will get the value from of this here. So this is 1 minus P of Z we will do this Z less than or equal to 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 1 minus 0.39. So which implies if I am taking this other side, this is P of Z less than or equal to 0.70 minus mu by sigma is equal to I am taking this here, this side and this here, 1 minus 0.39. So that are same. And there is a mistake. I made a mistake. What I done is there is a mistake. Now, this is greater than or equal to. So, which implies what I will do is. Set greater than or equal to 70 minus mu. Okay, there is a mistake here. So what I will do is later I edit. So P of Z greater. So this is actually equal to P of Z less than or equal to 70 minus mu, which implies is equal to the difference of 1 minus 0.39. Right. So this is the correct. If P of Z greater than or equal to 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 0.39, then P of Z less than or equal to 70 minus mu by sigma is 1 minus 0.39. Okay, have you got it? So now what we will do is 1 minus 0.39 is equal to 0.61. So P of Z less than or equal to 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 0.61. So that is the correct. So I have made a mistake. Okay. So that is equal to now this is 0.61. So if I draw the table curve, 0.61 is greater than 0.5, so it is in the positive side. So 70 minus mu by sigma is in the positive side. So from the table I have to calculate this 0.61. So 0.61 from the positive side. So positive side I will calculate 0.61. 0.61 is somewhere here. 0.61. So here it is 0.6130. Here it is 0.6064. This is this difference is bigger, and here it is 0.6141. So there is difference is bigger. So what I will do is I will take this quantity. This is the closest value for 0.61. This is the closest value, right? 0.6103.
Is it 0.275?
Yes, it is 0.278. This is 8, right? 0.08. So 0.2. 0.28. Not we doesn't want to take the average, because why? Because here it is 0.64 and here it is 0.103. okay, so we have to take the closest value. Adinu munpu endukondu average eduthathu? അതിൻ ആ രണ്ട് അടുത്തടുത്തുള്ള രണ്ട് വാല്യൂൻ്റെയും പ്രോബബിലിറ്റി സെയിമാണ്, ഏകദേശം ഡിഫറൻസ് സെയിം ആയതുകൊണ്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ എന്തെടുത്തത് ആവറേജ്. ബട്ട് ഹിയർ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ദി ക്ലോസസ്റ്റ് പോയിൻ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദീസ് ടു ആർ നോട്ട് ക്ലോസ് ടു 0.0 0.61. ഓക്കെ, സോ I will take this. So 0.28 is equal to, therefore 70 minus mu by sigma is equal to 0.28. Now we will get 70 minus mu is equal to 0.28 sigma. Therefore mu minus 0.28 sigma is equal to 70. Now we will get the two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. And, so equation 2 is this, and equation 1 is mu minus 1.55 sigma equal to 60. So from these two equations, you can get mu and sigma. So you just calculate this. And do all these problems. I have shared that question in your Google Classroom, and also I will